sir. Lot 665, ladies and gentlemen. A papier-mâché musical box in the shape of a barrel organ. Attached, the figure of a monkey in Persian robes playing the cymbals. This item, discovered in the vaults of the theater, still in working order.
Showing here.
May I commence at 20 francs? Oh, come, ladies and gentlemen. 15, then. 15 I am bid. Thank you.
20?
Yes, 20 from you, sir. Thank you very much.
25.
25 on my left. Thank you, madam. 25, I am bid. 30? Selling at 30 francs, then. 30 once. 30 twice. Sold for 30 francs to the Comte de Chagny. Thank you once again, sir.
Boy. A collector's piece, indeed. Every detail. Exactly as she said. She often spoke of you, my friend. Your velvet lining and your figurine of lead. Will you still play when all the rest of us are dead?
Lot 666, then. A chandelier in pieces. Some of you may recall the strange affair of the Phantom of the Opera, a mystery never fully explained. We are told, ladies and gentlemen, that this is the very chandelier which figures in the famous disaster. Our workshops have restored it and fitted parts of it with wiring for new electric light, so we may get a hint of how it may look when reassembled. Perhaps we may frighten away the ghost of so many years with a little illumination. Gentlemen!
Thank you.
Gaspari Chindras.
No. Signor, if you please, Rome. We say Rome, not Roma.
Si, room, not Roma. It's very hard for me. Room.
Once again then, if you please, Signor. Sad to return. Gentlemen, right this way. Rehearsals, as you can see, are underway for the new production of Chalumeau's Hannibal. Ladies and gentlemen, some of you may perhaps have already met Monsieur André and Monsieur Fernand.
I'm sorry, Monsieur Lefebvre. We are rehearsing. If you wouldn't mind waiting a moment.
My apologies, Monsieur Rayet. Proceed.
Thank you, Monsieur. Sad to return, Signor.
Monsieur Rayet, our chief repetitor. Rather a tyrant, I'm afraid.
Sad to return to find the land we love. Threatened once more by Rome's far-reaching grasp. Tomorrow we shall break the chains of Rome. Tonight rejoice, your enemy has come home.
Signor Pianti, our principal tenor. He doesn't play so beautifully opposite La Carlotta.
Gentlemen, please, if you could kindly stand to one side.
My apologies, Madame Giry. Madame Giry, our ballet mistress. I don't mind confessing, Monsieur Fermat, I shan't be sorry to get rid of the whole blessed business.
I keep asking you, Monsieur, why exactly are you retiring?
Funny, you two. We take particular pride in the excellence of our ballet. Monsieur Gilles André and Richard Fermat. Messieurs, Signora Carlotta Giudicelli, our leading soprano for 5 seasons now.
Ah, yes, I have experienced all of your greatest roles, Signora.
And Signor Ubaldo Pianchi.
An honor, Signor.
Piacere.
If I remember rightly, Elisa has a rather fine aria in Act 3 of Hannibal. I wonder if, as a personal favor, you would oblige us with a private rendition, unless, of course, Monsieur Rayet objects.
My manager commands, Monsieur Rayet.
My diva commands. Will 2 bars be sufficient introduction?
2 bars will be quite sufficient.
Signor.
Maestro.
landed down here. Bouquet, chief of the flies, he's responsible for this. Bouquet, for God's sakes, man, what's going on up there?
Please, monsieur, don't look at me. As God's my witness, I was not at my post. Please, monsieur, there's no one there, and if there is, well, then it must be a ghost.
Good heavens, I have never known such insolence.
Signora, please. These things do happen.
These things do happen? You have been here 5 minutes. What do you know? See, these things do happen. All the time. For the past 3 years, these things do happen. And did you stop them from happening? No. And you, you're as bad as him. These things do happen. Well, unless you stop these things from happening, this thing does not happen. Ubaldo, andiamo!
Amateurs!
It's yours. I don't think there's much more I can do to assist you. Good luck! If you need me, I shall be in Frankfurt.
La Carlotta will be back.
Oh, you think so, messieurs? I have a message, sir, from the opera ghost.
Good heavens, you're all obsessed!
He merely welcomes you to his opera house, commands that you leave box 5 open for his use, and reminds you that his salary is due.
His salary?
Monsieur Lefebvre paid him 25,000 francs a month, but perhaps you could afford more with the Vicomte de Chagny as your patron.
Madame, I had hoped to have made that announcement myself.
Will the Vicomte be attending tonight's performance, monsieur?
In our box.
Madame, who is the understudy for the role?
There is no understudy, monsieur. The production is new.
Christine Dye can sing it, sir.
The chorister!
She's been taking lessons from a great teacher.
From whom?
I don't know, sir.
Oh, no, not you as well. Can you believe it? A full house and we have to cancel.
No, let her sing for you, monsieur. She has been well taught.
Very well.
From the beginning of the aria, then, mademoiselle?
Thank you. Yes, you did well. He will be pleased. And you! You were a disgrace tonight! Such rendezvous, such soliloquies! Come, we rehearse! Now!
I think we've made quite a discovery here at Miss Dyer.
Here we are, Mr. Le Vicomte.
Gentlemen, if you wouldn't mind, this is one visit I should prefer to make unaccompanied.
As you wish, monsieur.
They appear to have met before.
Christine Dyer, where is your red scarf?
Monsieur?
You can't have lost it. After all the trouble I took, I was just 14 and soaked to the skin.
Because you had run into the sea to fetch my scarf. Oh, Raoul, so it is you.
Christine.
Little Lottie, let her my quander.
Remember that, too.
Little Lottie, but am I fonder of dolls
or
of goblins, of shoes
or of riddles of flowers?
Those tickets in the attic.
Or of chocolates.
Father playing the violin.
As we read to each other dark stories from the north.
Basking in your glory, ignorant.
great fool, this brave young suitor, sharing in my triumph.
Thank you.
pay homage to music. Music.
Must return. Those two fools who run my theater will be missing you.
Like yellow parchment is his skin. A great black hole serves as the nose which never grew. You must be always on your guard, or he will catch you with his magical lasso.
Those who speak of what they know find too late that prudent silence is wise. Joseph Bouquet, hold your tongue! He will burn you with the heat of his eyes.
Mystery, after call one night, he says, mystery of Soprano's wife. Mystified, Apple Surete, say we are mystified. Suspect foul play, God who's on so. First Carlotta, now Christine. Still, at least the seats get sold. Gossip's worth its weight in gold. Diva tenders resignation. Cover does a moonlight flit. Half your cast disappears, but the crowd still cheers. Opera, to hell with book in hand. You'll have a scandal, you're sure to have a hit.
Damnable, will they all walk out? This is damnable.
Our trick speech don't shout, it's publicity. And the take is fast free publicity.
But we have no past. But Andre, have you seen the cue?
Ah, it seems you've got one too. Dear Andre, what a charming gala. Christine enjoyed a great success. We were hardly bereft when Carlotta left. Otherwise, the chorus was entrancing, but the dancing was a lamentable mess.
Dear Fairmont, just a brief reminder, my salary has not been paid. Send in care of the ghost by return of post PTO. No one likes a debtor, so it's better if my orders are obeyed. Who would have the gall to send this? Someone with a pure vile brain. These are both signed OG. Who the hell is he? Opera ghost. It's really not amusing. He's abusing our position in audition. He wants money. He's a funny sort of specter to expect a large retainer. Nothing plainer. He is clearly
crazy. You mean Carlotta? I'm Miss Diane. Where is she?
Well, how should we not want an answer? I take it that you sent me this note. What's all this nonsense?
Of course not.
Don't look at
us. She's not with you then.
Of course not.
aren't you? Isn't this the letter you wrote? And what is it that we're meant to have written?
Do not fear for Miss Daye. The angel of music has her under his wing. Make no attempt to see her again.
Well, if you didn't write it, who did?
Welcome back.
The present future,
what is it now?
Of course not.
As if you wanted
it.
Of course not. What's going on? Is it that I meant to have sent?
Your days at the opera populaire are numbered. Christine Daae will be singing on your behalf tonight. Be prepared for a great misfortune should you attempt to take her place.
Far too many notes for my taste. And most of them about Christine. All we've heard since we came is Miss Daye's name.
Miss Daye has returned.
In which case I think our meeting is adjourned.
Where precisely is she now?
I thought it best that she went home. She needed rest.
May I see her?
No, monsieur, she will see no one.
Will she say?
Here I have a note.
Let me see it.
Gentlemen, I have now sent you several notes of the most amiable nature, detailing how my theater is to be run. You have not followed my instructions. I shall give you one last chance.
Christine Daae has returned to you, and I am anxious her career should progress. In the new production of Il Muto, you will therefore cast Carlotta as the page boy, and put Miss Daae in the role of Countess. The role which Miss Daae plays must fortune. And a plea, the role of the page boy is silent, which makes my casting in a word ideal. I shall watch the performance from my own seat in box 5, which will be a happy for me. Should these commands be ignored, a disaster beyond your imagination will occur.
I remain, gentlemen, your obedient servant, O.G.
Christine!
Whatever next?
It's all employed to have Christine!
This is insane!
I know who said this! The bishop of the
world! Indeed, can you believe this?
This
is a joke, she just not seen!
You are a star!
And always will be
seen! You're wrong!
The man is mad, he don't take orders! This guy will be playing the page boy, the silent role, Carla! Playing the lead.
You don't deserve her.
It's just a strike to the past me. God, I'm saving this the past me. So better you, the love of your dear, the love of your dear, the love of your dear, the love of your dear.
The scorn is so everywhere to go. The angel sings, the angel
from the mother of
Prima donna.
lady on the stage. Your devotees are on their knees to implore you. Can you bow out when they're shouting your name?
Think of how they all
leave you with your new maid. Though I
The old fool's leaving.
I suspect my young bride is untrue to me. I shall not leave, but shall hide over there to observe her. Adieu!
that.
Those eyes that burn.
Don't even think.
He has to kill a thousand men.
Forget this wink. This phantom is a fable, believe me.
Thank you.
beside me.
Masquerade, hide your face. crab, tell a crab.
Watching us, watching us.
Prosperous year
to a new chandelier.
May its splendor never change.
What a blessed release, and what a master of grace.
You can't contract a secret engagement, and your future bride. Just think of it.
But why is it secret? What have we to hide?
You promised me.
Let them see it's an engagement, not a crime. Christine, what are you afraid of?
Let's not
alarm
them. Please pretend
we will understand.
Yeah.
was. I shall never forget this. A man locked in a cage.
In a cage?
Oh, a prodigy, monsieur. Scholar, architect, musician.
A composer.
And an inventor, too. They boasted he once built for the Shah of Persia a maze of mirrors.
Who was this man?
A freak of nature, more monster than man.
Deformed.
From birth, it seemed.
My God.
But then he went missing, he escaped.
Go on. Did he?
The world forgot him, but I never can. For in this darkness
I have seen phantoms this man.
I have said too much, monsieur.
No,
too
wait.
Much, and there have been too many accidents.
Wait. Accidents. Madame Jerry!
Simply ludicrous.
It's the final straw.
This is lunacy, don't you know, my kids?
It's a lunacy.
But we can't refuse.
Not another chandelier.
Look, my friend, what we have here.
Dear Andre, be my orchestrations. We need another first bassoon. Every note's overblown, and that third trombone has to go. The man could not be deaf, so please preferably one who plays in tune.
Dear Annisa, be my opera. Some chorus members must be sat. If you could find out which has a sense of pitch, wisely go. I've managed to assign a rather minor role to those who cannot act. Dying quite the lady of the hour.
You have secured the largest role in this Don Juan.
Christine Daae, she doesn't have the voice.
Signora, please.
Then I take it you're agreeing.
She's behind this.
It appears we have no choice.
She's the one behind this. Christine Daae, how dare you? I'm not the fool. Evil woman, how dare you? You think I'm lying?
This isn't my fault. I don't have any part in this plot.
Surely,
but why not?
What does she say?
It's your decision, but why not?
She's backing out.
You have a duty.
I cannot sing a duty or not.
Christine, Christine, you don't have to. They can't make you.
Please, monsieur, another note.
Fondest greetings to you. A few instructions just before rehearsal starts.
Call out on your speedboat to act. Not the normal trick of striking on the stage. Out of one must lose some weight. It's not healthy as a man of Pianchi's age. And my managers must learn that their place is in an office, not the arts. As for Miss Christine Daae, no doubt she do her best, it's true. Her teacher, your obedient friend.
I won't do it.
Have all been blind, and yet the answer is staring us in the eyes. This could be the chance to ensnare our clever friend.
We'll listen, Joe.
We shall play his game, perform his work, but remember we hold the ace. For if Miss Daye sings, he is certain to attack.
We make certain the doors are barred. We make certain our men are
we make certain they're armed. The curtain falls. His reign will end.
I'm
not so sure.
Now take your
this
course.
Is
the time will turn.
Don't believe me. That is no way of turning the tide.
Please get down, Daye.
Help us.
Monsieur, I can't.
Instead of warning us, help us.
I wish I could.
Don't make excuses. Or could it be that you're on his side?
She says I'm coming.
Tangle with Don Juan,
if you please.
those who tumble with Don Juan.
No, nearly, but no. Those who tan, tan, tan.
Those who tan, tan, tan.
His way is better. At least he makes it sound like music.
Signora, would you speak that way in the presence of the composer?
The composer isn't here, and if he was, I would...
Are you so certain of that, Signora?
Once again, then, after seven. Five, six, seven.
Those who tumble with Don Juan.
Oh, yeah.
sick. Come.
Christy, listen to me. Whatever you may believe, this man, this thing is not your father. Sick. Let her go, for God's sake! Let her go! Christine!
Bro!
Bravo, monsieur, such spirited words! More tricks, monsieur! More deception! More violence!
Oh, that's right!
That's right! Keep coming this way! Let's see, monsieur, how far you dare go!
No!
You can't win her love by making her your prisoner!
Oh, no!
Stay back! I'm here! The angel of death! Come on, monsieur! Don't stop! So be it! Now, let it be war upon you both!
Go ahead then.
Are the doors secure?
Secure. 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 Secure.
I'm here, the phantom of the opera. I'm here, the phantom of the opera. I'm here. I'm here.
I'm here! Idiot! You'll kill someone! I said only when the time comes!
But Monsieur le Vicomte!
No buts! For once, Monsieur le Vicomte is wrong. See, I hate tonight. I need to have to cut the fun short, but the joke's wearing thin.
You come home, I use your voice, slam the door, the crack of death.
is assured if I do not forget myself enough.
To that moment, we'll speak. turn.
That condemns me to wallow in blood has also denied me the joys of the flesh. Disface the infection which poisons our love. Disface which burned mother's fear and loathing. A mask, my first feeling scrap of clothing. Pity comes too late. Turn around and face your fate. An eternity of this before your eyes.
It's
We have a guest.
No!
This is indeed an unparalleled delight. I had rather hoped that you would come. Now, my wish comes true. You have truly made my night. Freer to what you feel, only freer. Have no pity, your lover makes a passionate plea.
This vow is useless.
I love her. Does that mean nothing? I love her. Show some compassion. The world shall know compassion to me. Christine, Christine, let me see her. Be my guest, sir. Monsieur, I bid you welcome. Did you think that I would harm her? Why should I make her pay for the sins which are yours? Order your fine horses now. Raise up your hands, let level up your eyes. Nothing can save you now, except perhaps Christine.
Thank you.
faces on parade. Masquerade, hide your face so the world will never find. Christine, I love you.
Oh. We're going to try not to keep you too long. So we're going to start with all the moms that helped us out. Who wants to start with the moms?
Hi, so we just want to give a big special shout out to Mrs. Guccione. She does a lot of the literally, without her, probably all of our props would be broken still. So we have to thank her for always fixing our props. So once again, thank you for everything that you do.
She helped us with costume measurements and supplies backstage, and basically anything we needed. So Ms. Danzig, please come up.
These flowers are for Mrs. Gilbert, who has basically been living backstage with us this past week. She's helped us immensely with hair, makeup, and costumes, and a lot of us, specifically the guys, wouldn't have been able to look as good as we do without her because they don't know how to do their own makeup. So, Mrs. Gilbert, these are great. Thank you. Okay, I put mine down because I thought I'd be crying. So, this is for Mrs. Wenz. This amazing woman helped us all through the musical process. She was kind, understanding, and always ready to lend a hand. She persevered when zippers didn't zip, when our masks were tied too tight, or when someone needed something sewn last minute. That is why I would like to thank Mrs. Wenz for being such an amazing presence backstage and for helping with a little bit of everything. She has done so much to help us, and she's been such a great help. This bouquet of flowers for Mrs. Warren, so.
This next set of flowers is for. calm down, I haven't said the name yet. For measuring. What do we have, like 85 students in here? Too many students to count. For measuring all of us to get these beautiful costumes, Mrs. Lancia, please come up and collect the flowers.
I'm gonna spend my last minute on this stage talking about my wonderful and incredible music teacher, and one and only snack stand saleswoman, Miss Biss. I've had Miss Biss as a teacher since I was 5 years old, and I've never met someone so inspiring and so willingly involved in our music careers and our lives in general as her. It's because of her that I personally can feel comfortable enough to continue my journey in music next semester. And I couldn't be more grateful for everything that you do for all of us. And we love you so much.
If any of you guys here have done theater before, but if you have, you know that the week before a show is absolute hell, and it is awful. It is absolutely terrible. None of us sleep. We're barely home, even though we're barely home as it is, and Miss Biss is the amazing human being that provides us with tea and makes sure that
we're able to not have to blow our vocal cords out and give us a rest when we have a deck week. And it's amazing if we didn't have her. School would be a lot harder to go to in the mornings for this entire week. So thank you so much, Ms. Bliss. We love you.
Mr. Murray. Coach. The highlight of my entire musical season was when I did a dance almost perfectly, but not quite, and she turned around to me and screamed in my face, "I am so proud of you right now that I could cry," and then I think she cried. Coach is one of the most caring, powerful, and talented women I've ever met in my life, and I couldn't be more grateful to have an inspiration like her.
But not only is she an amazing musical director, but she was also playing in the pit this evening. She supports our productions so much, and she has become a friend to everyone in this production. And we love you, Ms. Meyer, so thank you.
Wonderful teacher, person, conductor, Mr. McCarter. For us seniors, Mr. McCarter has been with us from Into the Woods to Fiddler to Chess and now Phantom, and he has had such an impact on all of our lives. Every day, even when you're talking about like masonry or yard work or everything. He's just such an amazing person and such a great leader of the pit and helper of AV and tech and everything. And just thank you from the cast for an incredible 4 years. So,
been in chamber and in school orchestra, and that's a lot of time with this orchestra. So every year we get Mr. McCarter a gag gift. The internet said that a custom-made bobblehead is a great gift to surprise it's a great gift to surprise the recipient, and that it is something they will have for years to come. It's right there. I would hope that you would keep whatever we gifted you and cherish it for all of eternity, but apparently this gift will guarantee that you do. The internet also said that bobbleheads are, quote, the perfect gift for any occasion. Which is great. But I just took their word for it. Bobblehead.com sounded like a trustworthy, totally objective source to search for gift ideas. And they were very adamant that this was a good idea, so I hope you like it. There's actually a part in our music we were working on that's a bunch of short, even notes in a row. You told us to imagine a row of creepy dolls saying, Mom, Mom, over and over again. So maybe when you walk by your desk or wherever you decide to display this and see this doll, you may be reminded of that horrifying yet helpful adult. Thank you for that and for all you've done for us and this school as a whole. And we've been so blessed to work with you.
I'm Caroline, and like Anya, and like all of us, I have also lived in the auditorium for the past 4 years. My speech is a little bit more serious, but I remember early in this pit season, it was January 18th, because I wrote it on my phone right when it happened, the pit played a C sharp instead of a C natural. And most of the time, all that warrants is like a down arrow or Mr. McCarter covering his ear and cringing in our direction. But instead of just saying it's C natural and moving on, Mr. McCarter told us to never settle. Not just in regards to music, but in regards to everything. When you look around the stage, you look at the 70 plus people up here, you look at the handmade chandelier that was added to this morning, you see how suffered music never settles. The whole production is evidence of never settling. We as musicians and as people have learned to never settle because of the incredible teachers we spend every second with. Mr. McCarter is literally the Phantom of the Opera. He's here, he's here, he's here. More specifically, Mr. McCarter has been here for the last 20 years. The Phantom of the Opera is Mr. McCarter's 20th production as pit director, and to commemorate that, the seniors of the pit orchestra have made a plaque that says, Mr. Daniel McCarter, 20th year as music director, thank you for your unrelenting passion and devotion to the spring musical, which will hang outside the auditorium for the whole school to see.
Because we want to, because we love not only the music itself, but also the people we get to spend 17 hours a week with. But the man who's devoted the most time, effort, and passion to this orchestra is the ultimate reason all of this is possible. For the past few weeks, he hasn't gone home once after school. He pushes himself to stay in this building 15 hours every day to work with his amazing audiovisual crew, and he continues to drive himself to spend his entire evening teaching us with silly but very memorable analogies and inspiring us to become independent and insightful young adults. This man has been directing the Pit Orchestra for 20 years, and supposedly has been doing so for another 12, for some reason. We have been here for 4 years, and are leaving in a few months. I don't know how to repay him for having such a significant impact on my life, and that's one of the hardest things to accept right now. So I'll try to thank him instead. To the musical and technical director, sitting, well, he used to be sitting right there, and I'm standing up here. Thank you for teaching us about music, artistry, craftsmanship, technology, and literally any life lesson that comes to mind. I feel like I've learned more from you these past 4 years than I ever have in my life. Thank you for making the auditorium a safe and quiet place for us to call home. Thank you for being so patient with us every time we messed up or just weren't paying attention. Thank you for listening to any and every problem we've had on our minds and for being so unbelievably genuine, kind, and warm-hearted with all your care and concern for your students. Thank you so much for everything you've done that I know I'll never be able to return. I know you'll meet countless other students, sitting right there, but at least understand how much we appreciate and admire you for absolutely anything and everything you've done for us. Given us more than anything I could ever hope to return, I certainly hope you'll still think of us fondly, when we said goodbye. And while these flowers may not last forever, I certainly hope our memories will, so that you'll remember us at least once in a while. Please promise us.
My name is Dan, and I work the lights for Mr. McCarter's tech group. If I had a dollar for every time I've been asked how in the world does Mr. McCarter run the pit and direct the tech crew at the same time, I would be one very rich man. And I mean, this question's always been kind of absurd to me, because there's only one real answer, and that's because he's Mr. McCarter. The amount of knowledge and sheer passion Mr. McCarter possesses for everything he does is incredibly inspirational and makes everyone around him want to be a better person.
We can confidently say that he is the best teacher and mentor that a student can ask for. It's crazy for us to think how far we've come over the years, and in very large part to Mr. McCarter and his constant guidance that he's given us. We, on behalf of the tech crew, just want to say thank you so much for everything you've taught us and for making AV and the musical the best high school experience for all of us. Also, on behalf of the entire tech crew, we would like to just shower you with a few gifts and our love and appreciation. Yet another bouquet, of course, for the man himself. And a wrench that comes in many shapes and sizes. For the man who is very handy. In your off time, when you're not at the school, you can watch The Princess Bride. And when you have even more free time in the summer, you can go to AMC for $50 and watch more movies. Thank you, Mr. McCarter.
Say he's the most dedicated person to his job I've ever met, and
Even today, he wouldn't stop coming and making sure that I was okay and that I could do this role. And he just inspires me to be a better singer every day. I'm gonna keep this really short because I know you guys might be a little bored. So this person has been an inspiration to me and the entire cast. This year I was actually named Student Director's Assistant, which is a huge honor. So I really got to work. I got to work really closely with all the directors and specifically this person. So I'm sure you all know by now, but Schwartz, Schwartz has an eye for detail and an ability to push the whole cast and every single person who may be shy, and that's the reason that we can do shows like this. Without a director like that, you really can't pull something like this off, and I'm proud to say that we were able to with his help. So these flowers are for Schwartz, and he's an amazing, amazing talented director. We love him so much.
Everyone. I just want to say a couple thank yous. I will try and keep it as brief as possible, but you can't keep it brief when you do something like this. You don't do this one person at a time. This is teams of people, including students. All the parents that helped out couldn't have done this without you. Backstage, it was a fleet of people, and we needed a fleet of people. It was incredible. Thank you. Did all the makeup, costumes, hair, everything. Kate Blitz, art teacher here, who did our playbill and our online playbill and handled all the ad purchases. Thank you so much. Paige. Paige, for all your work as student assistant director, thank you so much. Made my life a lot easier. Mary Guccione, who's been doing props with me for many years and marching band with me, thank you so much. Linda Raschuti, who made those awesome posters on the dressing room and has helped us backstage. Caroline Fernandez, my drum major, who also did our headshots out there, thank you so much. It's a family thing. Audrey McCarter, right? Audrey McCarter sewed that entire gold curtain, made that curtain. Thank you. All the teachers and administrators who have been so supportive, even when we take a ninth of the school on a district tour, the week of a show when they're already exhausted and can't do homework, I really appreciate it. We all really appreciate it. Our custodians here, who are here as late as we are and as much as we are, headed by Hugh Maxwell. Thank you so much. Our alumni that came back this whole weekend and that reached out, whether they were in Florence, Italy, who played the Phantom before Gabe Wernick, and just everybody that reached out and came, thank you. This is a family. You can tell it's a family, and we really don't say goodbye. We just say, see you soon. So thank you. Peter Kincaid and Alice Biss, this doesn't happen without them being there during the day, every day as well. Band teacher, chorus teacher, mentors, they're responsible for what you see here as well. thank you so much, not just for working back there, but for working back there. Really appreciate it. Thank you. To someone that maybe a lot of you don't know, Peter Kramer. Peter Kramer, for many, many years, has covered high school theater in the Hudson Valley, covering about 65 high school shows every spring for LoHUD. And this past year, his budget was cut completely, and they don't cover high school theater anymore. And first of all, this is worthy of front page, and all of these high school theater programs are worthy of front page. That hurt, but for Peter, who is a friend, he is a friend to us, and he came to an entire rehearsal this past week. He didn't view any other shows. He did a write-up of us. It was such a sweet thing for him to have done. We really love him very much, so Peter Kramer, thank you. We have three casts. If this is your only show, you saw the main cast. We have a main cast, an understudy cast, and a concert cast. And yes, if it sounds crazy, that's because it is. And it's crazy good. And the people that were in those casts made us so proud. And the future of this program is really bright. And I hope you come back to see that brightness as they get older and more mature and more talented each year. So to those guys, thank you, understudy and concert. Our five production staff spouses, Joe Dranoff, Brian Meyer, Lauren Murray, Natalie McCarter, Tina Schwartz, thank you for not really understanding, but understanding all the time that we give. And to our kids, thank you. We'll be home soon. Really, thank you so much. We couldn't do this without your love and support. Thank you. Two more minutes, really quick. The set that you see here, I heard over the last few days, man, where'd they rent that from? Where'd they buy that from? Where'd they buy? None of this was rented. None of the costumes were rented. This was not rented. All of the things that you saw up here, lowered and raised and showing in front of you at all times, none of it was rented. The crews here built it, and they built it with blood, sweat, and tears, and it's amazing. It's Broadway caliber, beautiful, and I hope you enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed seeing it come together. This band, the stage crew, you're wonderful. Thank you, and indescribable how amazing it is. To the Pit Orchestra, you're incredible. If you notice a pit, it's because they played a wrong note, and if you don't notice them, it's because they're perfect. I think we could all agree, we notice them because they were perfect. The hours, the passion that we have for this, it really is a wonderful time. We love coming to work. We love it a lot. And finally, I just want to say thank you to the entire Suffern community, Suffern School District, for your support. Our budget is funded entirely by ticket sales and ad purchases. It is because of you, and especially the overwhelming sizes of our audiences this year, that have ensured that our program will continue to thrive, even after the most costly musical we've ever produced. I hope to see you all next year. Thank you for staying for these speeches, and thank you for coming out and joining us.
Hey, hey, listen to me, just listen.
Hey, hey, just listen to me.
mean, some people say a man is made out of mud. A poor man's made out of muscle and blood. Muscle and blood and skin and bones. A mind that is weak and a back that is grown. You load 16 tons and what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. Out of poor life and his London child. Picked on a tray out of water and glass. Loaded 16 tons of copper and gold. And the straw box he said, here's my soul. You load 16 tons and what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. To the company store. If you see me crawling better, step aside. A lot of men did it and a lot of men died. One fist of iron and the other of steel. If the rabble don't get you, then the left one will. You load 9 coal. I owe my soul.